This is a chapter right out of your Unluckiest Things That Ever Happened To Me book, a story you'll no doubt be regaling people with for the rest of your life. One night, you're driving down the highway as happy as a hamster with a new running wheel because you just had a great first date. Then you notice the dreaded red and blue lights flashing in your mirror. You pull over, not concerned because, hey, your car's in tip-top shape, you weren't speeding, and you're a law-abiding citizen. The cop approaches the car and after some questions says, "Step out of the vehicle, please." He thinks you look loaded up on booze and wants you to blow into a machine. You're just happy, that's all. You haven't had a drop. Nada. You haven't been anywhere near alcohol. And you blow positive. What's going on, you wonder? Before we get to the real story of when this happened, let's first tell you a bit about breath test devices, aka breathalyzers, that are used by the cops to check if you're driving under the influence. When you drink booze, that booze gets into your bloodstream, but the machine isn't testing your blood, since blood testing in the street would feel kind of invasive. The alcohol-tainted blood passes through the lungs, and that can come out of the mouth as vapor, called breath alcohol. Those machines are equipped to detect microscopic alcohol molecules and then estimate something called your blood alcohol concentration, often abbreviated to BAC. With a low BAC, you might appear to be normal, so the cops might be on a hunch. When it's a bit higher, you might experience mild euphoria, such as you were feeling after that first date. As some of you will know, when it's high, you might be incoherent and basically stupid. Higher still, and you might just pass out. There are different kinds of machines, but they all have a margin of error, meaning that they can be wrong and you could perhaps blow a false positive. You might also blow a false negative. Some reasons they could be wrong include the device not being calibrated properly, or even some leftover booze that's still in your mouth, even though you haven't had enough to be over the limit. But what we're talking about today is someone blowing positive for over the limit and not having touched a single drop of booze. There are a lot of myths out there which say things such as toothpaste might make you blow over, but they're all just myths. But the experts say products that contain alcohol could affect the test, stuff such as mouthwash and breath fresheners. Smoking might even make a small difference, and according to one paper, we found some cold and flu liquid mixtures and other medications that could also affect the results. There is a very slight chance that some candies containing menthol could affect the result, and then something like wine vinegar could also do the same. The chance of you blowing over due to consuming these things, though, one researcher said, it's pretty much inconceivable. But our story is much stranger than someone blowing over because of any of these reasons. The cops in this case might rightly arrest the guy on suspicion of drunken driving, but the guy was also right in that he hadn't had one single drink. This was no malfunction of the machine, and he hadn't just downed a glass of mouthwash, smoked a load of cigarettes, and then decided to eat two packets of menthol candies. He actually was drunk. Even though he hadn't been drinking, the cops and he were both right. Let us explain. In this case, it happened in 2019, the 46-year-old British man was driving in his car when he got pulled over by the cops. The media didn't give his name, so let's call him Danny. Drunk Danny. The police must have noticed that this guy looked like he was buzzing and so asked the man to take a test. He refused, but then he was arrested on suspicion of drunk driving. The guy was subsequently sent to a nearby hospital and guess what? It turned out that his BAC was twice over the legal limit. The man protested his innocence, and while he was right in saying he hadn't had a drink, he was unequivocally twice over the limit. And Danny isn't alone. There are cases of this happening in the USA and beyond. It must be very frustrating for the non-drinking drunks when they're told they've broken the law. In 2015 in New York, a woman was pulled over and she blew four times over the limit and she hadn't touched a drop either. Like Danny, she wasn't eventually found guilty of any wrongdoing for the same reasons he wasn't. In Danny's case, some researchers found out what had happened. It turns out that he had a weird condition that can make him drunk without him imbibing in booze. Danny could get drunk on life. Those researchers discovered that he had a certain kind of fungi inside his digestive system, and this was turning his carbohydrates into booze. He had his own fermentation system, and he could get drunk all by himself. This is a very rare condition known as Auto-brewery Syndrome. It might not sound terrible getting drunk for free, but a woman who wrote a book called My Gut Makes Alcohol said it was just an awful thing to happen since feeling all weird without having had a drink can really discombobulate a person. It can wreck relationships, get a person into trouble, and cause health problems. There was a case in 2011 in the US which involved a man who had to start taking antibiotics because of an injury. Then something strange happened to him. He began getting aggressive toward people and started forgetting stuff. The guy didn't know what was happening to him, and he looked for help after getting arrested for drunk driving. A researcher who worked on his case said this about him. Everybody thought he was a liar, that he was a closet drinker. Imagine not drinking and people accusing you of being loaded. With this condition, you can even smell like booze too. Tests were performed in which the man was asked to eat carbohydrates carbohydrate-heavy meals, and then researchers watched as he suddenly got drunk and his BAC shot up. He was told to stay off the heavy carbs, but seems he didn't, and at one point, he had a nasty fall which resulted in a brain bleed. He liked pizza, it was reported, and the bread was not good for him. In the end, he was given antifungal medications and other drugs, but the media reports he still skipped meals now and again just in case he got suddenly very drunk. It seems the course of antibiotics for his injury set his condition off, with those pills altering his fungal growth. He became the personification of a home brewery kit. The independent newspaper in the UK reported another guy in the US. He had to drop out of college because he was vomiting and having terrible headaches. He'd slur his words and have bad hand-eye coordination. He got drunk on nothing and had hangovers on nothing. He also got a DUI charge, but he was convicted. He did appeal this, though. His wife actually didn't believe him and started recording him to see if he was having a sneaky drink. She then realized he was not drinking at all. The man told the media, "She would watch me wake up and sit on the couch from the moment I woke up to the moment I went to sleep and progressively get more and more drunk." In his case, it took years for doctors to discover he had Auto-brewery Syndrome. One researcher said she works with 200 people in the US who have this condition, but another 500 folks from around the world have contacted her about it. She said it really is no fun at all. People could be up to 5 times over the legal limit with it, and it could happen so often that there is a potential for alcohol poisoning and, in the long term, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. She said people might not exactly feel drunk, but suddenly have a change in mood and become delirious, depressed, and dizzy. She also believes that a lot more people are living with it than we think. Some people just don't know what's making them feel so crazy at times. One guy had it for 20 years and didn't know. Would you want to be afflicted with this condition? We still haven't decided for ourselves, but tell us in the comments. Now go watch The Only Man to Survive 2 Nuclear Bombs. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.